Chapter 2 is developing a connected learner model. And you're going to love this chapter. What I basically did was started to think about, okay, so if I'm a connected learner, how could I leverage what I know to be the best hope we have for education in the 20th century? And that's professional learning communities. It's bringing teachers together in a face-to-face capacity to have very deep, meaningful conversations around what's working with kids, around what works and why it works and what we should do when it doesn't work, and really leveraging that collective intelligence in the building. And I started thinking, well, there's got to be a way to take these technologies, the way that we're connecting with each other on Twitter and blogs and podcasts and things like that, and be able to leverage that wisdom and bring it back to the local community. So this is where I really, in this chapter, I start to think about and build the case for a three-pronged approach. And the three-pronged approach basically is looking at professional learning communities in the context that most of us understand it, Rick and Becky DeFore, Bob Ecker, Shirley Horde, those kinds of folks, and the way they've laid that out. Then also thinking about, okay, how can we bring in the PLN, the personal learning network, thinking around, I go online, I develop this network literacy, I find individuals who are talking about things that align with my school improvement plan at school, talking about things that personally I want to grow and learn from, and so that PLN piece, that personal learning network, and then combine that with the communities of practice or the communities of inquiry, which are face-to-face or online communities where we learn deeply from each other, not just around student achievement and student success, but in those community spaces, it's really more about teacher reflection, deeply reflecting on my practice and thinking about how can I become a better educator, the bigger kinds of concepts of improving and growing and becoming better at the art and craft of teaching and learning, but doing it in a community of inquiry or a community of practice where we do it collaboratively, so that over time we build this intelligence, we do this knowledge construction collaboratively. So chapter 2, we'll talk about how those three can mingle together and through that three-pronged approach create a connected learning community rather than professional learning communities that's really going to position you well for teaching and learning in the 21st century.